And we will continue here on US Open Now, talking about recovery, talking about everything that has to do with the players and them getting ready and also recovering here at the US Open. They have been competing and they have been relying on the medical support. And as we continue our little series and kind of highlighting some of these amazing doctors from Mount Sinai who are here and at the ready, I had a chance to catch up with one of them. It is time once again for Doc Talk, presented by Mount Sinai, and I am joined by Dr. Eric Small, and he has a very impressive title, so I'm going to read it off the page. Sports medicine physician specializing in pediatric acute injuries, overuse injuries, and sports concussion, and a player physician here at the U.S. Open. A shorter way to say that is pediatric sports medicine.
That's correct.
That's correct. And you have quite the extensive background in this, both professionally and as a parent, I understand. I want to talk about that first, because you told me as we were getting ready that your boys have been ball boys here at the U.S. Open. What was that experience like as a parent?
Right, it was an amazing experience, although we didn't get free tickets, but we attended their matches, not for the players, but to watch them run around, chase the balls down. Since 2011, and they looked forward to meeting the players and the ball boys from all over the world. In fact, they have a ball boy group chat still going on.
Really?
for 8 years. Yes.
That's so cool. So obviously, this is an event very near and dear to your heart. What is it like being on the medical side of this event?
Okay. It's a lot of fun treating professional players who do that for a living. They're motivated to get better. They're motivated to return to their sport, and they listen to medical advice, unlike people who aren't doing it for a living.
Sure. And tell us a little bit, you know, as we talk about kids and getting kids involved in sports and particularly tennis, what are some tips, you know, to kind of engage the kids to get them involved and interested?
The most important thing to get kids involved in fitness and sports is to be active yourself. So as a father of four young men now, mm-hmm. The most important thing was running around with them and getting involved in sports in the backyard and encouraging them. Nowadays, we see a lot of parents who just look at the result instead of having fun. So the most important thing about sports and kids is to have fun and to encourage them to pursue what they want to do.
And what is the biggest benefit to getting involved in sports, especially maybe team sports at a young age?
At a young age, it's important. It builds self-esteem. It mm-hmm. builds leadership qualities. It teaches children how to deal with adversity. If you're not going to lose or win every time, it teaches adversity. It also teaches mental aspects of focus on physical conditioning, bone health, and general muscle strength.
Are there particular sports that you recommend as a doctor as maybe better ones to be involved in at a young age than others?
Well, sure. You want to encourage sports that involve movement, mm-hmm. which is tennis, which is soccer, which is basketball, things where you're doing a lot of running rather than being sedentary. So children love to move around, and they got to channel that energy.
All right, let's take it to our fans and see what they're saying out there. As always, we love for you to get involved here on Twitter using the hashtag US Open Now and also hashtag Doc Talk. And John wondering, should young athletes specialize in one sport, or should they try to play as many as possible? What do you think?
Okay, that's a great question. Sports specialization leads to burnout and overuse injuries, and something like 70% of kids who are playing organized sports and specializing quit by the time they're 13.
Oh,
so
wow.
We don't really want to specialize till high school. And when you play a variety of sports, you're more likely to be a better athlete and stay with sports for a lifetime.
And you specialized in sports and tennis in particular, right? A pretty good career, I would say.
Okay, well, I did baseball and tennis through high school, and I played tennis in college, and I taught tennis through medical school. And now I'm a player physician for the U.S. Open. How good is that?
I know. It's come completely full circle for you, right?
Right.
That's awesome. Well, enjoy your time here at the U.S. Open, and thanks for joining us on Doc Talk.
Thanks for having me.